So far, some studies have been done on theoretical design of a series of sandwich complexes of this general formula containing copper, silver, and gold, with both organic and inorganic ligands, and with different charges, and also with counter anions included where necessary. This research was inspired by the works dated by 2011 and 2013, and in the work published in GPCA in 2011, these type of complexes for nickel, palladium, and platinum were studied, and I am currently investigating similar complexes, but as I said, with copper or silver or gold instead of these three metals. Okay, and now about collaborative projects. There are several collaborative projects at the department here which I'm pursuing. One is investigation of ruthenium diphosphine pyrimidine complexes possessing potential anti-mycobacterium tuberculosis activity and cytotoxicity. This is performed in collaboration with the research group of Professor Batista. One publication within this joint project was submitted to Journal of the Brazilian Chemical Society. Here is the title of this publication. And these kind of complexes were investigated within this research, as we can see, containing ruthenium and iron, and also nitrogen and phosphorus centers. And another research is currently ongoing. Within this research, three isomeric complexes of this general formula are investigated. Again, as we can see, containing ruthenium center, two nitrogen centers, and two phosphorus centers, with different orientations of CO and chlorine relative to each other, and also relative to these dinitrogen and diphosphorus ligands. Subject of my computational studies here is relative energies of these three complexes, charges on atoms around ruthenium center, compositions and also composition of highest occupied molecular orbital. And here I use bisrelip with different basis sets. Another collaborative project is investigation of electrochemically reduced graphene oxide. This is performed in collaboration with the research group of Professor Pereira. Currently, computational studies of the graphene sheet model, which is tilted here, containing 42 carbon atoms, are performed with the following theoretical approach. Of course, here what is important is to investigate different multiplicities of this system, and because we can imagine that there are a lot of unpaired electrons here, and of course to investigate how different solvents could affect this structure, and of course potentially in future this model could be increased. So to approach better to the graphene sheets. Third project is devoted to investigation of gold nanoparticles passivated with these dimeric ligands containing either containing sulfur or selenium or tellurium, in collaboration with research group of Professor Camargo. The goal is to clarify the reason of non-linear dependence of ligand oxidation percentage on the X stage. Here, different DFT approaches, DFT approach with different functionals and different basis sets and different nanoparticle models is being used. And this scheme just shows how ligands with different with different atoms, sulfur, selenium, or tellurium, behave on this kind of model with gold, gold 20 upon geometry optimization with Bisrelip approach. So as we can see, sulfur ligands containing sulfur actually are looked like they are detached from the surface, and ligand containing selenium is partially detached, and ligands containing tellurium are kept not detached, which is also in line, as we can see, with changes in binding energy of ligands towards surface calculated. The fourth collaborative project is devoted to investigation of titanium O2 nanoparticle interactions in solvent, collaboration with research groups of Professor Andre Farias de Maura and Professor Edson Leite. And there is also one outside collaborative project which covers the topics of assignment of electron transfer mechanisms in cytochrome BC1. This is the title of this manuscript, which is currently in preparation. And this is done in collaboration with research groups of Professor David Beratan at Duke University, and also in collaboration with Dr. Shahar Keinan in University of North Carolina, say, almost same place. Also, here I would like to mention that in 2014, I participated in the joint project grant application with the following name. Unfortunately, it was rejected. And also, later I submitted my own proposal to CNPq. Unfortunately, it was rejected again, but experience. Last semester, I was teaching the graduate course with the name Introduction to Computational Chemistry. And this semester, we'll be teaching the graduate course Quantum Chemistry, Theoretical Basis and Practical Applications. Okay. Thank you for your attention. Questions?
Professor?
Yes.
As you discussed about a very interesting white. But is it possible experimentally to replace nitrogen by phosphorus? Is some researcher done this before?
Experimentally, compounds with one pyrrole nitrogen replaced with phosphorus, they were synthesized and characterized by different.
The whole moiety.
Only one pyrrole nitrogen substituted with phosphorus. As far as I know, only one research group actually or maybe two research groups focused on this kind of investigation. Their focus was on synthesis and structural and electrochemical characterization. They also studied catalytic activity for some of those compounds, and they studied both naked pyrroles and pyrroles for several transition metals. I think it was palladium and platinum and maybe a couple of more transition metals. And of course, those pyrroles which they studied were highly substituted. Not like in my case, because actually I have naked porphyrin molecule just for phosphorus instead of for nitrogens. But in their case, they developed the synthetic procedure for obtaining porphyrin with one phosphorus. So I think apparently yes. I suppose that yes. But I haven't seen any experimental studies for porphyrins with two or three or four phosphorus. Just with one. I don't know, maybe it's too hard so far, or maybe people are not interested, or I don't know.
Except if computational chemistry, it needs other environmental factor and other changes from greater. So
yes.
Doesn't allow.
Sorry, what?
Maybe this factor doesn't allow the whole system to be replaced with phosphorus. The whole.
Maybe.
It needs more research.
Yes. To to develop suitable reaction medium, yeah, of course, to develop suitable reactants.
And you are focusing only on complexes. For example, we have nature products like alkaloids, a very good moiety, sterols, sterides. Have you done some research on this side, just as nature products?
No, not yet. Not yet.
Why you are so interested in organic metallic, this type of chemistry, complex chemistry?
I started to be involved with this project metal tetraphosphoporphyrins when I still was in the US at Duke University. How it started, I was supervising an undergraduate student, and when I explained her how to do computational chemistry, how to work with the Gaussian software, I suggested for her to take as a project several porphyrins, nickel porphyrins with different substituents. Different substituents in meso and in beta positions, with substituents electron donating, electron withdrawing, like C fluorine 3, for instance, or NO2, bromine, and also just for myself, I thought, what would happen if I replace all four nitrogens with phosphorus? Yeah, I replaced it and I optimized the structure, and suddenly I saw, it's a ball-like shape. Yes, so these results were combined with results obtained for nickel porphyrins with different substituents, and that paper was published in 2012, I think. Yes, and then when I came here, I proceeded with that research, and I decided to extend it to see what would happen with other transition metals, because as you can imagine. We could have compound with some interesting structure and properties, but only for one metal, right? And with other metal, it could have quite different structure and properties. But when I tried it for other metals like scandium, iron, zinc, copper, I saw that general features are retained. Structure, all of them have this ball-like structure. And of course, charge distribution is completely different from that of parental porphyrins, and other details like homoluma gaps or optical gaps are also different. So with nickel tetraphosphoporphyrin, it wasn't something like artifact. It was in line. Yeah, it was the trend, the tendency was kept. For along with other transition metals.